Hello, we're going to be having a look at what you need to know about file handling for the exam. So let's start by just talking about why we even are learning this. This whole topic relates to dealing with external files. So you've got a file which has your program code in it. We've also got other files. Those are called external files. And we're talking about either writing to these external files or reading from these external files. And why even use these? Well, we have a problem in that I can have variables and I can have arrays which hold values. So I can kind of memorize values, but they're actually only ever held in RAM. And RAM, as you know from paper one, is volatile. So as soon as power gets lost, these get forgotten about. And also, even beyond that, to be honest, even if your computer is still on, once you close your program, RAM will forget about the values you held, right? It's why if you run your program again, the variable won't necessarily be the same value it was before because it gets reset every single time. So we have this issue where we're not storing stuff permanently. If I want to store stuff permanently, which you often do, they need to be saved to secondary storage. So the contents of your variables, the contents of your arrays must get saved to something like an SSD, which is non-volatile. And programs do this all the time, right? For example, a video game, I might be faced with a screen where I can load in previous saves. When I've saved the video game, it's been saved to an external file, and I've loaded in that save so that I can continue where I left off. Even in a more boring program, when I'm saving a PowerPoint file, for example, PowerPoint itself is a file. We are saving this particular .pptx to a separate external file. We do this all the time in programming because we just have to store stuff permanently. We don't want to just have to reset and start again every single time. So a Minecraft save file and a PowerPoint file are external files. They're in a complicated file format. We're going to at GCSE look at just a really plain file format. So we can always assume we are dealing with text files. A text file isn't even something like Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word's .docx is a much more complicated file than a text file. A text file is just ASCII characters, or here it's actually Unicode characters in a file. There's nothing else, there's no underlining, no colors, just Unicode. So here I've got a file called names.txt. All files have got file names. And I've got four names held on separate lines. And let's say I wanted to ask the user for a new name and save this to this text file. I want to make sure the name isn't forgotten about. So there is a kind of three-step process to writing to a text file. We first of all need to open this text file. So we have to open it whether we are reading or writing. We do this for both. This is effectively loading this text file into RAM, and also you're kind of asking the OS to give you access to it. So we have a variable, we assign it to be equal to an open function, which has the file name in it. The third and final step, so to skip our middle step, we always have to close a text file. So once I open it, that's all well and good, I can start using it. But when I'm finished with it, I need to close it. That's really important. You often get a mark just for closing it. Here is the syntax in both OCR ERL and also Python. And the middle bit depends on what you are doing exactly, so whether you are reading or writing. In this first example, let's write. So we're going to first of all ask the user to enter a name. I'm assigning it to be a variable. Then I'm using a .writeLine command to write the contents of this variable to this text file. And when this code runs, after it runs, if I type in John when asked, John will get written as a separate line to this text file. If I close my program, the text file will still have John in it because it's now saved to secondary storage. So this code here, like all my videos, is showing OCR ERL because that's what you need to be able to recognize in the exam. And it's a good example of where actually something like Python is a little bit more complicated to do. The code is pretty similar in Python, but it's a little bit more complicated. You might want to use ERL for the exam, even if you're good at Python, because quite frankly, it's a little bit simpler. And another thing which doesn't exist in Python, but does exist in OCR's world, is a function which allows us to create a file. So if the file doesn't yet exist, I'm assuming that I've already got a names.txt here. If it doesn't yet exist, I can create it before doing anything to it. So let's say I want to create a file called numbers.txt, and I'm then going to ask the user to enter three numbers, and I want to write each number to this text file. This is how I might do it. But this first line is this new bit of code, which creates a new file called numbers.txt. I still have to open it afterwards, still got to close it afterwards. But it means when the code runs, if I typed in 5, 9, and 4 when asked, it would end up saving these values to the file. .writeLine would always add it to the end of the file, always on a new line. I've left the input as a string here because text files only ever work with strings. So I need to write strings to the text file, and any values in a text file, when we try and read them, will also be strings. So it's important you understand that. Let's look at how we can do the opposite process, where I've already got a text file and I want to load in some data held in this text file. Here is a short text file called test.txt. The first line is a question and the second line is an answer. I might want to read these values into my program, and let's say I want to store the question as a variable and the answer as a variable. Well, how would I do this? Well, it's always the same three-step process. I have to first of all open my text file using open and our file name. I've given it a slightly different variable name here, not that it really matters. Then at the end, you've got to close it. And the middle process is where you are actually either reading or writing. In OCR ERL, to read a line in the text file, we write the text file name, then we do dot read line. And nothing will go in the brackets here. We still put brackets because it's still a subprogram. And dot read line, we are imagining, is clever enough to basically memorize where it's up to. First time I use dot read line, it'll give us our top line. The next time I use it, it'll give us the second line. And if I use it a third time, it'd be our third line, and so on and so on. So we don't have to tell it what line to look at. It just does it one by one. And just to extend this code, because the question might ask you to do something with this information. At this point, I've got my question and my answer loaded into my program, so I can do stuff with it. I can do some processing. Here, I'm asking the user for question given in the text file. I'm then comparing it to the answer given in the text file, see if they were correct. If they're not correct, I'm going to tell them the answer again using the text file. And the benefit could be that this code can stay the same, but if I wanted to change my question or my answer, I can just modify my text file and the program will adapt to whatever is in the text file. Commonly though, when we're using .readline, we won't use it kind of manually like this, where we're doing it one by one. Typically, we'll use a loop to iterate through every line in a file. And if I had more questions, that would be more realistic as an example, where I want to use a loop to go through all of these lines. Here's how OCR will present it in the exam and how you can use it in your answer if you want to. Python has got a couple of ways to do this. Actually, arguably Python is a little bit simpler here, but this is how OCR will show it. So it's important you are aware of this. Again, we always open, we always close, no matter whether we're reading or writing. We are reading here. And we're using a while loop because OCR have made up this file.endofFile command. .endofFile will tell you whether it is, whether it's finished with all the lines or not. So once readline has got to the end, this will be true. So therefore, we'll not reverse it to be false, so that when it's not the end of a file, we're going to read more lines. And this particular code here would just print out all the lines in this file, no matter how big the file is. We won't always be printing, so let's have a look at how we can do this in a more contextual example. We're told to write a program that loads in all scores in the text file scores.txt. Each score is held on separate lines. We're not being shown what this looks like here. We just have to imagine, which is often how it works in programming. Often you've got to write code without seeing the actual external file. It should then print out the largest score in this text file. Fairly chunky code, which I'll just show you. We always have the same three-step process. We open our file, we do some processing with it, we then close it, and we can't forget to close it. In this particular case, our processing is to essentially read in the first line of this file. I'm casting it to be a real because all lines in a text file are strings by default, and it needs to be a number so that I can compare it to another number using a greater than sign here. I've chosen a real because I can't see what's in this file, so I don't know for sure whether they are integers or floats, so real is a little bit safer in that way. I'm using my slightly odd while loop, which is the OCR convention, where effectively we're just going through every line in this file. I'm reading in the next lines and comparing to see whether that new line is bigger than our current largest. Largest score is not necessarily the largest score initially. We're just keeping track of what is our current largest. If it gets beaten in size by a new score, we update our largest score to be equal to that line. And I repeat and repeat and repeat until it runs out of lines to read. Then the while loop ends, I close my file, and then I print the largest was whatever was the largest score held in that variable. We typically want to close our files as soon as I'm done with the file. You could always put this as your last line, but typically we want to kind of wrap up as soon as we finish with our file. So that's why I've put this close line before this print line, but it's not really important for your answers.